Welcome to Chronicles of Time Sleep Stories. Finding moments of peace in the hustle and bustle of our lives can be a bit challenging. Our channel is your sanctuary, a place where captivating tales blend with soothing tones, guiding you toward restful slumber. Escape from the noise, let go of the day's stresses, and allow our stories to transport you to realms of tranquility and dreams. Whether you're seeking relaxation, meditation, or simply a good night's sleep, you're in the right place. So, settle in, close your eyes, and let the journey to serenity begin. In our unceasing journey through the corridors of life, moments of pure, unadulterated tranquility can sometimes seem as elusive as shadows at noon. The modern world is a symphony of endless noises, from the incessant hum of digital screens to the ceaseless whispers of obligations, commitments, and desires. In this symphony, our souls often search for a gentle lullaby, a melodious escape, a chance to pause, breathe, and simply be. Now, as you find yourself here in the magic of this narrative oasis, know that you've stumbled upon a sanctuary, a world where serenity isn't just a luxury but a promise. Picture, if you will, a secluded haven nestled amidst nature's embrace, where the wind hums lullabies and time itself seems to tread lightly. This is where we invite you to journey with us, a place of meditation, reflection, and utter calm. Begin by taking a deep, resolute breath. Feel the cool air grace your nostrils, traveling through the depths of your lungs, filling your being with the ancient rhythms of existence. And then, as you exhale, imagine releasing the shackles of worry, stress, and the relentless march of time. Each subsequent breath is a step deeper into the heart of tranquility, a dance with the universe, an affirmation of the present moment. We live in an era where the very essence of our existence often feels fragmented. Pulled in myriad directions by demands, expectations, and the invisible threads of technology, it's easy to lose oneself. But these tales, each a gem sculpted from the rich tapestries of imagination and insight, seek to offer you a bridge. A bridge not just to sleep, but that in itself is a cherished realm of restoration, but to a state of soulful relaxation, where the world narrows down to the here and now, where every heartbeat is a reminder of life's simple beauties. These stories are not just words. They are portals. They beckon you into worlds where the pace is gentler, the colors more vivid, and the sounds harmoniously aligned with the rhythms of the cosmos. Here, amidst these tales, you'll find characters and landscapes that resonate with the deepest parts of your psyche, invoking a sense of familiarity and nostalgia. They're like old friends or forgotten dreams, waiting to welcome you back. As you immerse yourself in these narratives, let the outside world fade into soft focus. Envision your stresses and anxieties as leaves carried away by a gentle stream, disappearing beyond the horizon. Let the weight of expectation, the clamor of responsibilities, and the noise of uncertainty be replaced by the soothing cadences of these stories. Every word, every phrase, is a brushstroke painting a world of peace, inviting you to step in and explore. Sleep, that precious gift, is not just a physical necessity but a balm for the soul. It's nature's way of healing, restoring, and rejuvenating. As you stand at the threshold of dreams, these tales are the gentle hands guiding you towards restful slumber. They remind you of the beauty of surrender, of letting go, of drifting into the comforting embrace of night. So, dear listener, as you embark on this journey with us, know that you are not alone. Through the magic of these tales, we are with you, sharing in your quest for tranquility and deep, restorative sleep. Let these stories be your anchor, your lighthouse, guiding you away from the tempests of daily life and into the calm waters of relaxation and dreams. Welcome to our sanctuary. Let the journey to serenity begin. Shadows of Anubis. Chapter 1. Whispers in the Sands. In the heart of Egypt, where the sands of time have buried countless secrets, Dr. Sarah Kensington, a renowned archaeologist and historian, stood at the threshold of an ancient mystery. The sun blazed down upon the Giza plateau, casting long shadows from the towering pyramids that stood as silent sentinels of history. Sarah's fascination with Egyptology had brought her to this land of pharaohs and legends numerous times, but this expedition was different. Reports had surfaced of a spectral jackal roaming the pyramids at night, an apparition that locals whispered was the manifestation of Anubis, the god of the afterlife. Skeptical yet intrigued, Sarah embarked on a quest to unravel the truth behind these eerie sightings. As she made her way towards the Great Pyramid, the largest of the Giza complex, the sand seemed to shift underfoot, whispering secrets of a bygone era. Her journey into the tombs below was a descent into the heart of ancient Egyptian beliefs and rituals. The air inside was cool and still, a stark contrast to the scorching heat outside. The corridors of the tomb were lined with hieroglyphs, each carving a story of life, death, and the journey to the afterlife. Sarah traced her fingers over the inscriptions, deciphering their meanings. The walls spoke of pharaohs and gods, of journeys through the underworld, and of the weighing of the heart against the feather of truth. Deeper within the tomb, Sarah discovered a chamber that had remained hidden for centuries. The chamber was adorned with intricate murals depicting Anubis in his jackal-headed form, overseeing the mummification process and guiding souls in the afterlife. Amidst the murals, she found references to the spectral jackal, depicted as a guardian wandering the land of the living. The murals told a tale of a sacred ritual gone awry, a ritual intended to summon Anubis's protection but instead unleashing a spectral entity bound to the pyramids. This entity, the murals suggested, was neither malevolent nor benign but rather a manifestation of Anubis's will, a guardian of ancient secrets. As night began to fall, Sarah emerged from the tomb, her mind swirling with the day's discoveries. The sight of the pyramids under the moonlit sky was both awe-inspiring and ominous. It was then that she first heard it, a distant howl, a sound that seemed to come from both everywhere and nowhere. Compelled by the howl, Sarah ventured towards the source. The sands of the desert shifted beneath her feet, leading her to the base of the Sphinx. The monolithic structure, with its enigmatic expression, seemed to gaze directly at her, as if beckoning her closer. Under the Sphinx's shadow, Sarah found an entrance to a previously undiscovered subterranean chamber. The chamber was a labyrinth of tunnels and passageways, each term revealing more about the mystery she sought to unravel. As she navigated the labyrinth, Sarah encountered carvings unlike any she had seen before. These carvings depicted the spectral jackal in various scenes, guarding tombs, roaming the desert, and standing at the gates of the underworld. The jackal was portrayed not just as a creature of the night, but as a symbol of protection and guidance. The labyrinth led Sarah to a central chamber, where an ancient artifact lay atop a stone pedestal. It was a statue of Anubis, crafted from obsidian, its eyes inlaid with gold. As she examined the artifact, the howl of the spectral jackal echoed through the chamber, resonating with a power that seemed to transcend time. Finally, Sarah makes a startling realization. The spectral jackal was not just a guardian of the pyramids, but also a key to unlocking deeper secrets of the ancient Egyptians' connection with the afterlife. Her quest to uncover the truth had just begun, leading her on a path that would intertwine her fate with the legends of Anubis and the mysteries of the ancient world. Chapter 2: The Sphinx's Riddle. Under the moonlit sky, the great Sphinx of Giza stood as a gateway to ancient secrets. Dr. Sarah Kensington, her heart pounding with anticipation, approached the colossal structure, its enigmatic gaze seeming to pierce through the veil of time. The desert night was alive with a chorus of whispers, and the air was charged with a sense of the mystical. As Sarah stood before the Sphinx, a voice emerged from the stillness, deep and resonant. The Sphinx, a guardian of knowledge and protector of mysteries, spoke to her, its words forming a riddle that echoed the wisdom of the ages. "I am the keeper of secrets, the guide to the hidden path. Two guardians stand at the gates of dawn and dusk. When they meet, the way forward is revealed. Who am I?" Sarah pondered the riddle, her mind weaving through the tapestry of Egyptian mythology and lore. The answer came to her in a moment of clarity, the horizon. As she spoke the answer, the ground beneath her shifted, revealing a hidden staircase leading down into the earth. Descending the staircase, Sarah found herself in an underground passage, the walls adorned with carvings and paintings that told stories of the Egyptian gods, their powers, and their realms. She marveled at the artistry, each detail a piece of a larger narrative about the balance of life and death, order and chaos. The passage led Sarah to a chamber beneath the Sphinx, a place of reverence and ancient power. The chamber was circular, with a domed ceiling that depicted the night sky as the ancient Egyptians had seen it, a map of stars and constellations in vibrant colors. In the center of the chamber stood a pedestal, and upon it lay a collection of artifacts, a golden ank, a scepter, and a scroll sealed with the symbol of Anubis. As Sarah examined these relics, she realized they were not merely ceremonial, they were keys to understanding the deeper mystery of the spectral jackal. The scroll, when unsealed, revealed a tale of a time when the gods walked among mortals. It spoke of Anubis's role as the protector of the dead and the guardian of sacred knowledge. The tale hinted at a hidden realm where the spectral jackal roamed, a realm that bridged the living and the dead. Compelled to uncover this realm, Sarah explored further, discovering a network of tunnels that branched out beneath the Giza plateau. These tunnels, long forgotten by time, were lined with hieroglyphs that told of a sacred ritual to summon Anubis's favor and protection. As Sarah journeyed through the labyrinth and tunnels, she encountered ancient traps and puzzles, each a test of her knowledge and intuition. The traps were ingeniously designed, from hidden pits to walls that shifted and closed, and Sarah navigated them with a combination of academic expertise and adventurous spirit. The chapter concludes with Sarah emerging into a vast underground gallery. Here, statues of Anubis stood in silent vigil, their jackal heads gazing into the darkness. At the far end of the gallery, a mural depicted the spectral jackal, its form shimmering with an ethereal light. The mural was a map, and Sarah realized that it pointed to the location of the spectral jackal's realm, a place where the boundaries of life and death blurred. Intrigued and determined, Sarah prepared to venture further into the heart of the mystery that connected the living world with the realm of Anubis. Her journey was about to take a turn into the unknown, where ancient myths and reality intertwined. Chapter 3. The Underworld's Gateway. Dr. Sarah Kensington's journey beneath the Sphinx led her deeper into the secrets of ancient Egypt. The mural she had discovered in the underground gallery was not just an artistic relic, it was a map to the realm of Anubis, a dimension where the spectral jackal roamed, a bridge between the living and the dead. Equipped with her extensive knowledge of Egyptian mythology and a resolute spirit, Sarah followed the map through a network of subterranean passages. The walls of these tunnels were lined with hieroglyphs and bas-reliefs depicting scenes from the Book of the Dead, guiding souls through the Duat, the Egyptian underworld. The air grew colder, and the darkness seemed to press in around her as she navigated the labyrinth. She encountered ancient mechanisms and puzzles that required not only her academic expertise, but also her intuition and ingenuity. These challenges tested her resolve, each one a guardian of the secrets she sought to uncover. After what seemed like an eternity in the underworld's maze, Sarah arrived at a grand chamber. In its center stood a massive statue of Anubis, the jackal-headed god, looming over a dais with a scale, the very scale used to weigh the hearts of the deceased against the feather of Maat. As Sarah approached the statue, the air around her shimmered, and the spectral jackal appeared. Its form was both fearsome and majestic, its eyes glowing with an otherworldly light. The jackal spoke in a voice that resonated through the chamber, revealing itself to be the guardian of a sacred artifact, a relic that held the power to control the boundaries between life and death. The jackal warned Sarah of a looming danger, a shadowy organization that sought to harness the artifact's power for their own dark purposes. The organization had already infiltrated the tombs and pyramids, searching for the key to unlocking the artifact's secrets. Determined to prevent the artifact from falling into the wrong hands, Sarah agreed to help the jackal. Her journey took her to the hidden corners of the Duat, through landscapes both beautiful and terrifying. She traversed fields of reeds, crossed rivers of fire, and navigated the halls of judgment, each step bringing her closer to the artifact. Throughout her journey, Sarah encountered the souls of the ancient Egyptians, some offering guidance and wisdom, others testing her resolve with riddles and challenges. She learned more about the ancient Egyptians' beliefs and rituals, gaining a deeper understanding of their connection to the afterlife. After that, Sarah reached the chamber of the artifact, a room bathed in a golden light, where the sacred relic was kept. However, she was not alone. Agents of the shadowy organization had followed her, intent on seizing the artifact. A battle ensued, a clash of modern-day intruders against the ancient powers of the underworld. Sarah, using her knowledge of the Duat and the aid of the spectral jackal, fought to protect the artifact. The chamber became a battleground between the forces of preservation and those of exploitation. In the end, Sarah emerged victorious, but the victory was bittersweet. The chamber had been damaged in the fight, and the stability of the portal between the worlds was at risk. With the help of the spectral jackal and the ancient magic of the Duet, Sarah worked to seal the portal, preventing further intrusion from the outside world. As the portal closed, the spectral jackal thanked Sarah for her bravery and dedication. It assured her that the artifact would remain safe within the Duet, guarded by the jackal and the ancient powers of the underworld. Chapter 4. Anubis's Judgment. With the portal to the underworld sealed and the artifact safely guarded, Dr. Sarah Kensington found herself standing before the massive statue of Anubis in the Grand Chamber once more. The spectral jackal, now at peace, had faded into the shadows, leaving Sarah to confront Anubis himself. The air around her grew dense, and a sense of ancient power filled the chamber. The statue of Anubis stirred to life, its stone features animating with supernatural grace. The god of the afterlife towered over Sarah, his presence both awe-inspiring and intimidating. Anubis spoke in a voice that resonated with the weight of millennia, acknowledging Sarah's bravery and wisdom. He revealed that the spectral jackal had been a test, a guardian not only of the physical artifact but also of the knowledge and power it represented. Anubis declared that Sarah had proven herself worthy of a deeper understanding of the mysteries of life and death. He offered her a choice, to return to her world with this knowledge or to delve deeper into the secrets of the Egyptian afterlife. Driven by her insatiable thirst for knowledge, Sarah chose the latter. Anubis then guided her on a journey through the Duet, showing her the realms that the souls of the departed journeyed through. She witnessed the fields of reeds, the Hall of Judgment, and the endless cycle of renewal that the ancient Egyptians believed in. As they journeyed, Anubis shared his wisdom on the balance of life and death, order and chaos, and the importance of preserving these balances. Sarah's understanding of ancient Egyptian beliefs deepened, and she realized that her journey was about more than uncovering a historical mystery. It was about understanding the fundamental truths of human existence. After what seemed like an eternity, Anubis brought Sarah back to the chamber. He imparted to her a final piece of knowledge, a deeper understanding of the ancient Egyptians' connection with the afterlife, which she was to share with the world. As the statue of Anubis returned to its inert state, Sarah found herself alone in the chamber once more, her mind brimming with new insights and revelations. She made her way back through the tunnels beneath the Sphinx, emerging into the cool night air of the desert. Finally, Sarah stands before the pyramids, looking up at the starry sky. She felt a profound connection to the ancient civilization that had built these timeless monuments, a connection that transcended time and space. Sarah returned to her world, but she was no longer the same. She carried with her the wisdom of Anubis and a deeper appreciation for the mysteries of the past. Her adventure in the sands of Egypt, the encounter with the spectral jackal, and the journey through the Duet had changed her, imbuing her with a sense of purpose to share the ancient knowledge she had gained. Sarah Kensington began a new chapter in her life, one where she would serve as a bridge between the ancient world and the modern, sharing the timeless wisdom of the Egyptians with all who sought to understand the mysteries of life and death.